Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Deanna, also known as D's Curve. If you are new here, I post plus size fashion, travel, and lifestyle related videos. I definitely think you should consider subscribing to my channel. Or if you don't subscribe right now, wait until the end. And if this video provided value to you, then go ahead and hit the subscribe button. I started a new series on my channel called There's No Name For It Yet. But basically, I'm just sharing tips on becoming a content creator. I have been doing this for a little while now, and obviously I am not where I want to be. I'm not a pro. I have so much more to learn, but I have picked up a few tips and tricks along the way. And there may be people on my channel who follows me, and even those who don't follow me, who may be aspiring content creators who need the tips as well. So I decided that I will just share the things that I've learned along the way. In the first video, I shared tips on how to batch create content. So if you haven't seen that one, I will link it above, and I'll also link it in the description box so you can go check it out. Today's video is gonna be all the tech things that you need to create content. I feel like this video is very timely because the day that the video goes live, I'm actually gonna upload this video a day early. I usually upload on Wednesdays. I'm gonna upload on a Tuesday because it's Prime Day, and literally all of the items I'm gonna share can be found on Amazon. Now, I don't know if they're gonna have sale on those specific items, but more than likely they will. And so I'm like, this is my opportunity to share these items with you guys. So if you're interested in learning about the different tech items that I use to create content, keep on watching. I wanted to first start off by saying you do not need any of these items. They are all things or tools that can enhance your content or can make it a little bit easier to create content. But I swear the only thing you need in terms of tech is a phone. If you have just enough money to invest in one thing and one thing only, I would recommend that you invest in a really good cell phone. So I think the newest iPhone right now that's out is an iPhone 14. You don't even need to have the 14 because I have an iPhone 11, and a lot of my content is filmed on my iPhone. As long as your lens is clean and you make sure your settings are good, then you only really need an iPhone. I mean, not an iPhone, a cell phone. You could use an Android too, but I don't have any experience in that. So I can only speak about an iPhone. So that is the first and only thing that you need. Everything else can come after. So don't let not having these things I'm gonna mention stop you from creating content if you really, really want to. If you have a good phone, literally all you need, and that's what pretty much most content creators started off with, is a phone. So okay, now that's out of the way, let's get into the first item. The first item you're going to need to create content is a camera. So if you are wanting to vlog or do sit down videos on YouTube, then I would highly recommend the Sony ZV-1 camera. It's actually the camera that I'm filming on right now, so I can't like hold it and show it to you, but I'll put up a picture here, and all of these items will be linked in the description box. This is like a really, really good entry level camera. I am not big on tech. Like, y'all, I'm very much entry level when it comes to like cameras and stuff. And when I got this camera, it was so easy to use. Honestly, you can keep it on the auto settings and you don't really need to change anything, and your quality is gonna be good. The mic on the camera is really good. You literally just, and also the good thing about this camera is it comes in a kit, and the kit comes with a tripod, and it's a really sturdy tripod. Actually, do I have the tripod? I don't have it right here, but it comes with a tripod, and so you can just buy the camera and the tripod together. I have had no issues with this camera. The size is perfect. It's very small. It can fit in most of my really small purses. It's also not very like heavy and awkward. So if you're like shy about vlogging, you can like pick it up and vlog really quick and put it back down. I absolutely love, love, love this camera. I've had it for like 2 years now, and it has done me well. I have gotten my money's worth. I would highly recommend this camera. The next item you're gonna need are memory cards. So one of the biggest issues I have with creating content is memory and not having enough storage. So I would highly recommend getting like a memory card with at least 128 gigabytes, because I have all these like 32 gigabytes, and I'm like, 32 is nothing, okay? You film one video and it's full. So 128, it's a little bit more expensive, but I would recommend that you invest in 128 gigabytes, or at least 64 to 128. And if you can go higher than that, then by all means, but it's a good place to start. Speaking of memory cards, this is a memory card case. You guys, as you can see, I have a ton of memory cards. Actually, I have another one right there. I have one in the camera right now. I have one right here. So basically, I fill up this whole case. And before I had this case, I would lose my memory cards a lot. I'm like, okay, where did I put it? Did I put it in the drawer? Did I put it in my purse? Like, where is that specific memory card? And then I'm trying to edit and I can't find the memory card. Now, every time I take a memory card out of my camera, I put it in this case. It's aluminum, it's sleek, it's small, it can fit in your purse. When I travel, this is like so good because I can keep my memory cards in one place. As a content creator, I think every content creator has had an incident where they lost a memory card. And when you lose it, it's like that's memories literally gone down the drain. Cannot be like, what's the word I'm looking for? You can't get it back, right? So I would recommend getting a case. It's very inexpensive, but I really like this one, and it can hold, I think, what, 8 memory cards. Now, if you have more than that, then maybe you don't need to carry all of them. You can keep it, you know, in your desk or whatever in your office, but this, highly recommend. The next item I wanted to share is a SD card reader. So I have this one, again, from Amazon. All of these items are from Amazon. And I really like this one because my laptop is a USB-C, so it can go directly into my laptop. And it also comes with a regular USB head. So you can, depending on the computer that you have, when you want to upload your content, it's very, very easy to just put the memory card in here and upload your content. Then I also have this, which I would recommend that you get, depending on, like, so for example, some of my items have this USB, the old one, and then some of them have this, right? So this is like an adapter, I guess it's called. So I can, like, you guys know what I'm saying, okay? I don't know the correct terms, but it's so I can use this with this product. So whatever this is called, an adapter, I believe, I would recommend it. Now, if all of your products have only one USB, then you don't really need this, but I found a lot of the products that I have, it comes with the old school USB. Like some of the products I'm gonna show you, it comes with the old school USB, but then a lot of my adapters that I use to charge is the new USB. So then I need to like convert. I think it's a converter. I think that's the word, a converter. So I need to convert it, so I use this. So I would recommend this little handy dandy device. The next item I would recommend that you get in your little starter content creator kit is one of these bad boys. This charges up at least 2 batteries. I have had one that charged 3 batteries at a time. These are the batteries that come with your camera. Also, when you buy this one, it comes with 2 extra batteries, which I really like. You can never have enough batteries. I have a ton of them. When you're doing travel content, especially, you're out on the road, you're not at home, the worst thing that could happen is your camera dies. Like, it's so unfortunate, and then you have to like, oh guys, I'm sorry, my camera's about to die, I'm gonna vlog on my phone. Ugh, absolutely hate that. So I always carry an extra battery with me, and at night I make sure I charge up my batteries. And this little thing, it charges it pretty quickly. Like, it'll light up when it's not charged, and it'll turn green when the batteries are ready, and that's when you know, okay, they're fully charged. So I would highly recommend this this charger. As I said, it comes with 2 batteries, which I love, and it's compatible with my specific camera. Of course, you would have to find one that's compatible with the camera that you have, but this little thing, it goes everywhere with me. So we're still on the topic of charging devices, and I have this battery pack. Now, this specific one I wouldn't recommend because it's on the bigger side. I've had this one for a very, very long time. They have made lots more like sleeker, smaller ones than this that I would recommend, or that I would like explore. I really need a new one, because this one, it can't really fit. If I have this, a battery, a light in my bag, my bag is full. So I know Apple has one that can like stick to the back of your phone and it's very, very sleek. So I'm considering getting that specific one, but I haven't invested in it yet. But I still wanted to show you that a battery pack, for the same reason, you don't want your phone to be dying halfway through your adventure and then you can't capture your content, you can't make memories. So you definitely need a battery pack. If you are a solo content creator, meaning you don't always have someone to help you create content, one of the disadvantages to that is there's not a lot of movement in your content, right? Because obviously, if you don't have someone helping you, like holding the camera, you're gonna have the camera stationary. There's this little tool and it's called a Pivo, came in this little kit. It has a Bluetooth remote. You put your phone on it, you connect it to your phone, and it will literally track your movement. So a lot of times when I'm vlogging or like I wanna create reels, and cause this wouldn't work on your camera, it's only for your phone. But if I want some movement in my content, I put my phone on there and I just like walk in front of it and it'll just like follow my movement. I think this is like, it was a little bit pricey, but I think it's a good investment. Again, it's not something that you need, but if you want to elevate your content, then I would recommend this little tool called the Pivo. The next item is this little light, this bad boy, okay? This little thing has gone viral on TikTok, on Instagram. So if you're into content creating, you probably have one of these, or you've at least seen it before. But this whole thing is so powerful, you guys. If you're going to a concert, if you're filming content at night, recommend, okay? This little thing, I would show you, but I don't know how well you're gonna see because obviously it's not nighttime right now, and I don't even know if this thing is charged. It might be dead. Yeah, I think it's dead. I need to charge it. But this little bad boy, it fits in your purse, and it really makes a difference with the lighting. I would recommend you need one of these. On the topic of light, another thing that you need as a content creator, if you are gonna be creating content at night or if you don't have a lot of natural lighting, you need a ring light. So right now I'm sitting in front of a window, so I have a light coming to me and I really like feminine natural light, but sometimes if I have to work and I gotta film at night, or if the sun isn't shining, you need light. I do still have my ring light on this side, so you know, it can like brighten my face. So you need a ring light. There's the basic ring light that you can use. I will link it below. And man, I could do like a whole video on lighting because there are lots of lighting options. But to start off, I would say just a ring light is more than enough. Like you don't need anything more than that, because I recently got new lights and it was probably like a few months ago. And as I said, I've been doing this for a while. So my ring light was working fine. So definitely a ring light. The final items that I wanted to talk about are tripods. Okay, and you are currently standing on a tripod. So as you can see, I have gone through a ton of tripods, definitely all not necessary, but I wanted to just quickly talk through them. So these two serve the same purpose. I went on a trip and I thought I lost this one. This is the one that came with my camera. This one is pretty cool. You can connect it to your camera and like control the camera with these buttons. I've honestly never used it. I've never used it, so it's not absolutely necessary. I went on a trip, I thought I lost this one, and so I bought this one. So basically, these are same purpose, okay? So this is handheld, you're vlogging. I actually prefer this one because it just feels very sturdy. And then you can open it up like this and sit your phone down. You can also adjust the neck. So like if you wanted the camera to sit further back, you can bring it back like this. You can go up like that. I like this one. This one, you can pretty much do the same thing. It's just not as intuitive. So like you have to press this and then hold this. So it's a little bit wonky to work with this one. But again, this one fits really nicely in your hands because it kind of feels natural. Because this one is square, it doesn't like completely feel natural. But I think this might be cheaper. This one came with my camera, so I don't know the price of this one individually. But honestly, either or would work for like vlogging, okay? You need this. Because holding your camera in your hand, it's almost like it's too close to you. You can't really extend. So you definitely You did. You need these, okay? Now this tripod, this specific one is for your phone, okay? So it's kind of like a selfie stick, but it can stand. Now this one I really won't recommend, but I wanted to show it to you because there's another version of this. It's a little bit bigger, so it goes a little bit taller and it's more sturdy, and I had that one but I left it in New York. Amanda, if you're watching, please mail it to me, but I just need to get a new one. So it looks very similar to this, like it's the same concept. The base is like that. It has a Bluetooth camera and you can extend it like this. You can also, like, when you close it, it's, this one is very small. The other one that I'm mentioning that I would recommend is a little bit bigger, a little bit thicker. Pause. but it's more sturdy, and when you want to create content on your phone, would super duper recommend that one. I need to get it back. Then we have this bad boy, which is a tripod that I would use when I'm filming like sit down videos on my camera. I really like this one because it's very heavy duty and you can like adjust it quite a bit. So you can go like this. You could almost do all the way overhead, but not fully. And then you could, you know, adjust this way as well. So I really like this one. As I said, it's very heavy duty. This is not something you want to carry with you everywhere you go. So I'm gonna switch out. I wanna show you another tripod because I have one more. This is the one that you're on right now. This one is my newest one. And you guys, I absolutely love it. The reason I love it is because, and I'll show you, like I'll be showing it on screen, okay? The reason I love it is because it's very, very easy to carry. It's very similar to this one and the other one that I would recommend that I lost in terms of size and in terms of concept, but you can put your camera on it. So the thing about these is it only has, you can only put your phone. See, it only has a holder for a phone. This one that you're on, the top of it looks like this. So you can screw on your camera on it. You can also screw on an adapter like this and put your phone on it. So really, you don't even need this one if you get the one that the camera is on that I'm showing you on the side right now. You guys, this thing is so good. I used it when I went to New Orleans because I love having a tripod with me that's like tall, and this one, it goes all the way up. I would really, really recommend if you had to like choose like a camera, a tripod, just one. If you only had to buy one tripod, this white one that I'm showing you right now, that would be the one that I recommended out of all the ones that I showed you. That is the end of today's video. Again, everything is going to be linked below, and I just wanted to reiterate that you do not need any of these items. The only thing you really need is your creativity, your mind, and a cell phone. If this was helpful to you, please subscribe, thumbs up, comment, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.